Now, street crews and paramedics, they are stocking up and getting ready. They expect to be busy when the storm hits. Eyewitness News 5's Wendell Edwards is live with our big story. Wendell.
Paul, is going to be so cold that many people are just bracing for that Arctic air. People here at this nursery buying wood for their fireplaces so they can stay warm when this cold air gets here.
Here is all of our sheets and blankets.
In the event of an emergency, preparation is paramount. And IMSA says it's getting ready.
Today's weather 60 degrees, and then typical Oklahoma for you, it's going to be freezing with snow on Sunday.
Freezing and cold. The Christmas Eve blizzard of 09 showed us just how bad conditions can get here. So IMSA is stocking their vehicles with ice melt and blankets just in case.
When you sign up for this job, everyone knows that, you know, when you have disasters or near disasters, real bad weather, we're always on alert.
Being ready is the key.
That's all we can do. And as we did last year, we don't know what the weather's going to provide for us. And all we can do is prepare up front.
28 salt and plow trucks are staged and ready to go. And city crews have already started pre-treating bridges and overpasses before the bad weather gets here.
It's been an awesome winter. I'm not complaining at all, and it's a lot better than 4 foot of snow.
Still, it will be cold, so plants should be protected, and so should skin. People with tickets to the Governor-elect Mary Fallon's inauguration are advised to dress in layers. We're told despite the frigid weather, this ceremony will go on. And also made several calls to school districts today, and they're telling me they too, administrators, are watching this weather closely. Their main concern is slick roads, but if school buses can get to school, then classes will go on too. Reporting live tonight, Wendell Edwards, Eyewitness News 5.
Wendell, thank you. Inauguration officials say if the event is moved indoors, they will make that call on early Monday morning.